Definitely the human-sized duck, because I would just knock him out cold. But 100 ducks, humans, is a little bit too tough, I guess.
Nee, just take the duck-sized humans, oh? Just
yeah, but then what? Yeah.
So step on them.
No,
duck's not so small, man.
Huh? The duck's small, man.
No, not small.
Yeah, it's no. Okay. Yeah, okay. It can take a while, but you can make it do it. I don't know. I think I would have more chance if I can just run and hit and run, basically, but...
But your size, I think, duck is more easy, oh?
My size duck?
Yeah, it's easy.
Well, maybe, yeah, true.
Just you want it.
Wrestle it.
Just want it. I would say my size duck, for sure. It's easy.
The most positive things are in the bootcamp, for sure. You can just focus on the game every single day. Everything gets prepared for you. You never need to think about something else, and that's the biggest upside, I would say, in the bootcamp. Especially also after a game, you have some company around, it doesn't matter positive or negative, and therefore it's always really nice to have people around you. Yeah, and of course, if you have always the same setup, you feel always comfortable, confident in the way things you are doing. Therefore, I'm glad to have always the same setup around me, especially here in the bootcamp, always really good equipment. Thank you, Backforce.
For me, living in the bootcamp or living in the house here is just, you're constantly in touch with CS. That's what was missing for me when I was living at home. I was too focused on other things, and that's why I made this decision earlier this year to move here to Berlin. And ever since then, I don't know, like, it's been nothing but positive. Like, we are getting treated like we are, like, I don't know, kings or something. We get, like, food every day, we have the best setup, we have, like, basically everything we need, and we also get the things we don't need, but we could need one day, so we just get them, and I don't know, it's nothing but good, and I'm just really happy that, like, how things have been turned out since I moved here. I think it depends on also the sides you're playing. For example, I'm like more of the beholder, and I like to play the 30 bullet M4 more, because I just have these extra bullets to like spam a smoke, to like disrupt timings, to maybe just get one last kill or one small more damage.
For me personally, I like the silencer more. It's cheaper, therefore you can buy one more grenade. Of course, it's positions depending. For example, rotator positions can easily play silencer. They can move around more often. It's a really nice silencer weapon because it's more accurate as well by running. It's silent as well. And greetings to Massa, of course. And therefore, yeah, I like the silencer more.
Like, I never tried before M4 silence, but I would say I think M4, like, normal one better for sight holder.
Do you ever want to try silencer?
Maybe one day.
I think German player. I think STFN has insane aiming. Stefan, my old teammate. Besides him, I really don't have any idea. I don't watch so much German CS anymore.
I like Thompson aim a lot, and Favon as well is very good aiming. I think this as well. It's insane aiming.
Thank
man.
You, man.
I would say in big German best aim, I would say it's definitely me or Tizi. Kito has as well, of course, sometimes really good aim, but only sometimes. No, I'm just joking. Other than that, I would say outside of big, there are not so many great aim players. I would say definitely Faven is one of the best in Germany. Maybe possibly Marky. He has decent aiming. Other than that, no idea.
Mine is very old school, but I like a lot. Ahmed Kaya name is.
I mainly listen to like rap, doesn't really matter where it comes from, mostly America or... Was, Alter? Ich höre auch Deutschrap.
Nee.
Doch.
Nee.
Na klar, ich höre übertrieben viel Deutschrap.
Wen denn so?
Ja, halt so Underground. Ja, Mann. Ich schwör. Ja,
aus Berlin kommen die.
Ja, aus Berlin, Bruder.
I listen to, I'm a mainstream guy. I'm listening to charts. Really good streams, nice charts. And when I deathmatch or I play nice Counter-Strike, I like to listen to old school frag movies, like for example rock or sometimes metal. And of course, for example, Linkin Park is always really nice. And yeah, that's my type of music.
I think you have to find a balance between your, between CS and your life. That you, I think when you're just playing CS all the time, you, your head kind of can't take, like, you just can't take everything that you're learning. I think just you will just miss some things that you're playing, as well as when you, for example, practice 10 hours a day, maybe the first 4 or 5 practices are going to be like really good, but in the end, it just gets really exhausting. Might even be like counterproductive because you, I don't know, start fighting with your teammates because everybody's kind of exhausted and doesn't really know what's going on.
I would say it's individually based. But personally, I have the experience that there's no practicing too much. Obviously, if you practice, for example, like there's an example like sports, for example, football players, they can't make, they don't practice like 5 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours a day. Obviously, your body get exhausted. Same goes for Counter-Strike players. I think mentally you get also exhausted. Therefore, you can just, for example, practice your aim a little bit, also study demos, watch your own game, and therefore you can as well, of course, get exhausted and practice too much in that case. But for me personally, I don't really feel that way, and I always try to be productive, yeah, and therefore I'm always practicing.
Most definitely. We are Germans, except Jan, but he's also a very good onliner, and online is our stage, so to say. No, but like jokes aside, I think we started this year pretty good off with the first 2 LAN events. We had really good LANs. We also like we won both LANs we attended this year. And when everything moved to online, I felt a little bit bad because I thought, like for the first time, we have a really good LAN team, but. Yeah, I mean, I guess shit happens and we still won tournaments, so it's fine.
For me, I would say we have an advantage because also we are basically still in a LAN situation, I would say. Like it's different than other teams. They are playing from home and it's definitely a different feeling because when I was at home, I was also playing one tournament from home and definitely felt different because you are just playing a game and then after the game you. It's basically like kind of done, and when you are in an environment where you're always basically in a working environment and playing tournaments and stuff, then you're always like in the mood to play tournaments all the time. Therefore, I would say it's an advantage and a disadvantage for us because also, like TC said, I think we had a really nice LAN experience, and we definitely missed it, and especially now after. Couple of months after 10 months, I definitely miss traveling a lot and also just yeah, getting away at some point and just enjoying the outside and yeah.
So for me, I don't care LAN or online, so both like same for me.
Usually I wake up 10 minutes before practice. Most of the time I come too late and I need to pay money to our coach. But if that's not the case, I wake up early, I go shower, then I directly go downstairs. I take a coffee, an espresso. Yeah, and then I'm taking my breakfast and I'm directly going to the PC and we start discussing things on the server.
As you can see, I'm tired. That's why my sleeping schedule or my waking up routine is most of the time I wake up, chill maybe 5 minutes in the bed to get like the nice mood to wake up. Then after I go to the bathroom, I shower, then I take my breakfast, which is already ready. Thanks for Nuran and as well our big management. Really grateful to have. Afterwards, going downstairs, getting another coffee, like TC said, and getting the mood to just start the day, of course. Then watching maybe HLTV, looking what's up. And then practice starts, 8-hour practice. I wake most likely 30 minutes before the practice, and then I just chill in the bed 10 minutes, and I do my breakfast after that, and I go downstairs and just chilling, Google, YouTube, something. That's it. Nothing. Nothing else.
I never really gave myself the chance to think about that, because when I was 16, I already joined my first team. When I was 17, I already joined my first full-time, like I signed my first full-time contract. So I always had my future in CS, like in my mind, and I, of course, it's a little bit of a risk, but I never really thought about the future without like games or Counter-Strike. And I always just hope that whenever my career is over, that I'm still somehow going to be working in the game or in the industry. And yeah, this is what I'm like putting my cards on.
Yeah, that's a tough question. I always, back in the days when I was a child, I always wanted to be a fireman. I always saw myself in there, I don't know why. Probably I saw too many movies. But I really, to be honest, I didn't really think about that. Like I'm living in the moment, and I live now, and yeah, therefore I'm glad to be here.
Nice, I like the deep answer.
Probably PC graphic, you know what is
designer,
PC graphic designer.
Oh.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, because before my job it was a PC designer, and if I just finish CS or something else, like I can just do it.
You make like websites and stuff like
no,
this?
No, not like this.
Like games? Like,
no, not like games.
More like logos?
Yeah, logos, oh, yeah, right, exactly. Yeah.
Cool. Man, my personal goal is definitely to not drop out of top 5. It's a huge achievement for us to stay this in a constant way, being a top 5 team in the world, beating top 1, top 2, top 3 teams maybe in the world. It's a huge achievement for us, for the whole German scene, of course. For me, my personal goal is definitely to get again to the number 1 spot, of course, to keep it longer than last time. Other than that, of course, win some tournaments here and there again, and to always keep remaining always this nice mood, this nice understanding of CS, and always try to develop even more. And of course, we just try to always be happy and enjoy life.
My goal would be, of course, to stay in the rankings, to stay in the at least top 5 rankings, hopefully reach top 1 again. This would obviously be my main goal, to just stay in top 5 and hit top 1 again. But I would also be satisfied with just staying in top 8, honestly. I know that it's really tough road, and I know that it's really hard to maintain such a high skill, especially if you play so many tournaments, like tournament after tournament. It gets really tough. You can't prepare so much anymore. It all gets a little bit close to each other. You don't have so much time anymore, and it's just all really stressful. So I hope that next year we, as I said, would stay in top 5 at least, and that hopefully the scene will grow a little bit healthier because of the tournaments, that we don't have to play like 3 tournaments in 1 month.
My goal is beat Vitality and try to stay like top 3 at least, and just finish the year like this. And I will do my best for the finish top 5.
There's definitely no other answer. I hope you guys know that. It's Vitality, Navi, and possibly right now Astralis or us. It's depending on the situation or depending on how the pressure hits someone. But I think that's the 3 top major playoffs teams.
No, I have the same answer. I think by far, like without a doubt, Vitality, then Navi, and then for sure Astralis. I think we are close to also getting in the top 3 ranking, but I think we are still missing a little bit, and we need to, like I said 2 years ago in a Cologne interview, that we still getting hit by pressure, and that we still need to try to handle it better.
Definitely Vitality and Astralis, and Navi and us, maybe. Definitely Furia.
Why?
Because you never expect what they do. They are just rushing through smokes. I don't know. Just everything they do. Random, yeah. I feel like.
Yeah. No, Furia is definitely hard to play. they are really what John said. Communication is always high pressure. You never know what's happening. Oh, blah, 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 blah. It's like high intense games. But I would say also playing against Vitality is really hard to play because they have good answers. You get punished really easily. They know exactly what they are doing. It's not like random stuff. It's a well thought process behind their actions.
I would also say like strategically it's Vitality by far because they just play really smart. They have really good answers and it's, I don't know, really, really tough to play against. But on the other hand, like surprising CS, I would say it's Furia. A lot of our members, like mates, tilted in the practice games against them because they did so much unexpected stuff. But I was I was just so happy when I played against them because I was so impressed by the things they were doing. I was like, wow, that's so good shit. That's so nice what they're doing. Like, Kito is like flaming so loud and I'm like sick, he's so sick. Like, I don't know, I'm really impressed by how they play and I really like it.